Hello everyone. In this video lecture, we will discuss about the basic concepts of computer networks. So now today topics are introduction about the computer network. After that, we are going to discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of computer network. Then what are the components are existing in computer network, types of different computer network. After that, we move on to the very next important topic, which is called as network topologies. So after that, what are the different devices are existing in your network, and lastly we discuss about OSI reference model. Before going to start actual definition of computer network, here we mention what is meant by network. A network is a group of two or more computers are linked together. What is the advantage of having this computer network nowadays? The main reason is to share the resources that are existing between different computers. So let us start with a small definition. So what is meant by network? Here, in any computing applications, more number of systems are interconnected to facilitate the transfer of data between one computer to the another computer. So here the network is nothing but it is a group of two or more computer systems are linked together. Here, this is the actual meaning of network. We are connecting one computer with the another with the help of some communication links. So, after that, so what is meant by computer network? Here, a computer network is a network, it's a collection of two or more computers and devices to interconnect and facilitate the sharing of resources. Here, the main advantage of using this topic is in order to share the resources. So what is meant by resource here? Like printer or any other computer application. Here the definition of computer network is nothing but it is a collection of computers and devices to interconnected to facilitate the sharing of resources. Here the key term which you are using in this definition is resource. Here the resource is nothing but like either printer or computer application. The best example here is if one computer software or application is installed on one computer, that application can be shared or accessible by other computers in a network. This can be happened with the help of only the networking concept. In order to make or share the data between the different computers, we are using the concept called as computer network. Here, this is the basic definition regarding it is a collection of computers and devices. The devices may be connected or interconnected to one computer with the another computer. That's why we can share the data from one system to the another system with the help of this networking concept. So you may use one printer. You can take the prints from all the computers in your department. Nearly 60 systems are existing in your lab. Only one printer are available. You can take printouts from the all the systems with the help of this networking concept. Here the resource will be shareable. Means the printer can be usable by anyone in the lab. So that's why we are selecting this networking concept is very familiar nowadays. You want to share not only the data, you want to share the music or photos or files or documents. Whatever the content of the data will be shared with the help of this networking concept. Next we move on to the next one, which is called as what are the advantages and disadvantages of computer? So now let us start the advantage and disadvantages of having this computer network. First, we start with the advantages of computer networks. Means, why we choose this one? The only theme point here is, in order to share the resources like printer or computer applications or files or data or music or photo, whatever the content you have in your system, that elements will be shared with the help of this networking concept. So, why you choose this computer network? The main advantages of having this computer network is, the first one is file sharing. In order to share the file, we need the networking concept. The second one is resource sharing. And the third one, increased storage capacity. And the next one will be increased cost efficiency. After that, load sharing. Next, we have facilitate communication. So these are the advantages of having the networking concept in your system. The first one is the file sharing. Here, what is meant by file? The file may be in the type of music or audio or file documentation. What kind of the files you have, that will be shared with the help of this networking concept. The example will be the music, photos, files, etc. Here, in network, a file is to be shared with the multiple users in a network. Means it will collaborate with all the computers in your system. You can share the data from one place to the another place with the help of this computer networking concept. The main advantage here is, in order to share the file between one system to the another system, it will provide the concept called as file sharing concept. Here, the first advantage of having this computer network will be the file sharing. After that, we have resource sharing. Here, just now we discussed, resource is nothing but like a printer or any computer application like software. That software can be installed in one computer. That software can be accessible and sharing by all the computers in a lab. So here the resource is nothing but here the printer or computer application. One software is installed on one computer and it will be accessible by other computers in a network. This can be happened only with the help of networking concept. So the third one will be the increased storage capacity. Here the increased storage capacity is nothing but it will increase the space of the system. How it will happen? For example, if any standalone system, means one system, can have the limited size of memory. Whereas if you interconnected between one computer with the another, automatically all memory space will available to the all the members in your network. So that's why it will automatically increase the storage capacity in your system. So which is very related to the next one, which is called as cost efficiency. Here the cost efficiency is nothing but, so here the best example is, I am going to buy only one computer application software. That software is to be installed on one computer. That service, that resource will be available to all other systems in your lab. It will automatically reduce the cost of your software. Means you don't have to buy 30 softwares or 30 software license or 30 software applications. We are only buying only one application. That application will be installed on main system, which is called it as server. At that server, we can going to interconnect all these systems. All these systems will be accessible with the help of this networking concept. It automatically reduces the cost efficiency. So that's why one of the main advantage of having this computer network here is the increased cost efficiency. The next topic is load sharing. Here, in order to transfer the jobs to the other systems on the same network, it will automatically increases the speed of the execution. That will be happened with the help of this load sharing. Means the jobs here, whatever the jobs that are existing in your computer, that computer jobs will be transferred to the another computer from the same network. It will automatically reduce the load on particular system. It is helpful to increase the faster execution also. That's why we can mention here, one of the advantages is load sharing. So after the final advantage of having computer networks is facilitate communication. Here the facilitate communication is nothing but instant messaging will be happened while all the computers are connected to a single network. The 60 systems or 80 system, whatever the system that are existing in your computer lab, all the members are going to share the information along with to communicate one system with the other system with the help of instant messaging or emailing. Here they are transferring one message from one system to the another message in the same network. It will receive the network at an instant time. So that's why it is called instant messaging. So that kind of facilities will be also available in computer network. That's why nowadays every computing application must have computer networking concept. So let us start the disadvantages of computer network. So students, up to now we discuss about what are the advantages of having this computer network. Now it will also have some disadvantages. The mainly three disadvantages of having, if you have any internet, if you have any networking connection between one or more computers, let us check what are the disadvantages are existing. If server fails, means if you are connecting more number of computers to a single network, any one of the system will act as a server. That server will provide the resources, access the resources to the other computers in a network. So at that time, if the server fails, the data cannot be accessed by the other members in the network, which leads to loss of data. It means if you have 10 systems in your lab, all 10 systems are to be connected or networking, and one of the system will act as a server. If that server fails, automatically the data cannot be accessible by the other members in the network, means another remaining 9 computers in your network. So which may lead to the loss of data. And another point is, if server hacks, hacking is nothing but some other unknown person hack your system, means accessing your system, which leads to the misuse of data. Here the misuse nothing but the hacker will hack the data and it may useful in another way. So this is another disadvantage of having, does not having the proper networking conditions. So the third one will be, if number of computers and devices exceed the permissible number, means it does not support more than 10, at that time the efficiency of the system decreases. Here, in order to maintain the proper networking, must and should follow some rules and regulations up to the set time limit only. If the limit exceeds, then the performance automatically decreases. And the last one will be, the network management is very difficult. The known person is going to handle this, all this networking connection. If improper management will lead to the loss of data as well as misuse of data also. That's why be careful while you are creating a connection between the one system to the another system with the help of this networking concept. Better try to make it have some proper guidance. If the networking management is not available, then it may lead to all the following content. So in this case, the network management is very difficult and tedious job. It's the known person only will handle all these management capabilities. So these are all the advantages and disadvantages of computer networks. So now let us start with the next topic, which is called as components of computer networks. So the next topic is components. So just now we learn about what is the advantage of computer network and what is the disadvantage of computer network. So the basic definition of the computer network. So it is better to have the networking between one or more computers. So that's why we can share all the resources, what are the existing in your system. So that resources will be useful to other members in the same network. So well and very good. Now what are, in order to make a connection or in order to make a networking concept, we need to have some components. Those are, here the first component will be connecting media. So connecting media, which is nothing but, so how you connect one computer with another computer? Either wired or wireless. You may connect one computer with another computer with the help of either wire or wireless, which comes under this connecting media here. This will be either wired connection or wireless connection. So the second component that are existing in computer networks is connecting devices. Here the device is nothing but, so many number of computers are to be connected. So the whole thing will be maintained by one of the connecting devices. Here the connecting devices are so many things like hub, switch, router, gateway, which comes under the next topic. So these connecting devices which helpful to transfer the data from one computer to the another computer. So the examples are, here is hub, switch, bridge, router or gateway. So after some time we will discuss all these connecting devices also, what are their functionalities. So after the third component, after the connecting devices, we have the third component, which is called as network topologies. In the content itself only you are seeing this heading, network topologies. Once again, this is a very key point in this networking concept. What is meant by topology here? Here the topology is nothing but layout or semantic description of arrangement of a network or structure. Simply we can say it as structure, in which structure all these systems are to be connected, either sequential or horizontal, either a ring or a star or a bus. Whatever the layout you are choosing, that comes under this topology, right? So topology is nothing but, again, bus topology. Some of the examples are ring and again star, mess. After that we have hybrid topology. So these are all about the network topologies. And the fourth component here is communication protocols. Here the protocol is nothing but set of rules and regulation. In order to make a connection between one computer with another computer, we must have some connecting media as well as connecting devices. Along with the topology, we must have some protocols. Here the protocols will give the guidelines how the packet, how the data will be transferred from the source to the destination. Here we can mention source and destination means two ends, one end A and the another end B. So the communication between A to B will have some certain set of rules. That rules can be specified by these protocols, which is called as TCP, IP and UDP protocols. So these are the main four components that are existing in order to make a communication or to make a interconnection between one computer with the another computer. This is the basic important points regarding these components of your computer network. We move on to the next topic, which is called as types of network. Here, types of network means, what is types of network here? In which way you are choosing this type, based upon their scope and scale of a network, which means the geographical area. If you have a small geographical area, then which type of network you are choosing? If you have large geographical area, then we can choose another type of network. So let us start with the first one, which is called as LAN, means local area network. So if the geographical area which is very small or limited area within the building or within your office or within your school or within your college, then the type of network should be in LAN, local area network. So here the basic theme of type of network is chosen based on scale and scope of a any network. So the geographical area which is very limited, like if you are having a building, in that building you are going to make or establishment a connection between the network, then you can choose this local area network. So the range will be very small range, very small range which comes under in buildings, schools, colleges, etc. So the geographical area, the scale of the area will be very limited size, then you can choose the type of the network will be the local area network, which we can also call it as LAN, LAN. Here systems which are connected in order to make a file sharing between these four computers, the four computers will be interconnected to this file server. Here the file server provides the resources. These resources will be accessible by each and every individual system in a network. So what are the remaining factors which consider this LAN is, a LAN may be of either wired or wireless. Here the connection is to be established with the help of communicating media. Here the communicating media either wired or wireless. Here the connection between one computer with the another computer, you can choose the transmission media either wired or wireless. If it is wired, you can use Ethernet cables or coaxial cables. From wireless, we can use, with the help of the radio waves, we can connect this system in a LAN network. Here all systems are to be interconnected with this LAN. The data or the files, whatever the mail server provides the resources, that resources will be sharing with the help of this LAN network. The connection or connecting media or communication links, we can also call it as communication links. That links can be either wired or wireless. So if it is wired, you are using Ethernet cables or telephone cables, or otherwise you are using wireless means, which is called radio waves. So the next point is, here the sharing the resources very effectively. For example, if a lab have 60 systems and only one printer, all 60 systems are accessing that printer with the help of this networking concept, that resource will be useful. With the help of this networking concept, all systems are to be interconnected. If any system can give the print, that prints will get onto this printer. Only one printer is needed to print the tablet. So after that we have, it provides high security. So this type of network connection provides very high security. After that, lack of privacy. Here the lack of privacy is nothing but any unauthorized user can also access this networks. This is the only disadvantage having in this network. It is suitable only for having very limited range of geographical area, means like buildings or offices or colleges uses this type of connections. So this is the first type of networking connection, which is called as local area network. So the range of this network will be very limited size. It's also provide high security, and another advantage is sharing of resources. Any kind of resources, here the resources may be like printer or computer application. Those resources can effectively share from one system to the another system in a network. So the only one disadvantage here is lack of privacy. Here the unauthorized user may also access this network. That's why little bit disadvantage are happening here. Better try to make careful regarding while authorized users only can access this network. So this is all about local area network. Second type of network is metropolitan, M-A-N, which is also known as metropolitan area network. Here the geographical area or the scale of the area larger than LAN, which is nothing but within a city. In order to make a interconnection between different branches in a city, we choose the network called as metropolitan area network. In simply means, you can within the city. Like better example is, if you have a bank main branch SBI, let us take SBI bank. The main branch will exist in Collectorate. So many number of branches are available in our city. So in order to interconnect those branches, we choose the network here is metropolitan area network. So the geographical area, which is larger than LAN and smaller than WAN. Here the WAN is the highest area comparing to the remaining networks. So larger than WAN and smaller than WAN. Within the city, we can choose this type of network. Within the city, here a number of branches are existing in a city. Those branches are to be interconnected with the help of this metropolitan area network. Here, one again, the advantage is sharing the data. Here, one branch will act as a server. Those servers will provide all the necessary resources to the other branches in a network. They can communicate, they can transfer files from one system to the another system or one branch to the another branch. They can share the information, they can copy the information, they can load the information. So another advantage here is, which is also have less security, the communication media here is fiber optics or cables. In order to create a communication between one branch to the other, here the communication media are useful is fiber optics or cables. It requires more number of cables. Here the main disadvantage here is requires more number of cables. More number of cables. And it is also a connection of different LANs. And one more important point here is a MAN is nothing but connection of different LANs. Here so many LANs are to be connected with the help of this MAN network, which covers the area larger than WAN and smaller than WAN, wide area network. Here the structure of metropolitan area network will be, I will show you here. This is the main network which acts as a server. And here, different LANs are existing. These LANs are to be interconnected with the help of this MAN. This is one LAN. And this is another LAN. So like this, we are, just now we are mentioning one point, connection of different LANs. So to make metropolitan area network, we use, if you have one LAN and another LAN here, those two LANs will be interconnected. This is the best example regarding metropolitan area network. Here, this is the bank main branch server. This is another branch server. And this one is another branch server. So these branches are interconnected with the another main branch. In order to transfer the data from one branch to the another branch, we choose the network type, which is called as metropolitan area network. So here the main advantage here is, once again, I remembering some points with the sharing the data, which in order to share the data between one branch to the another branch, choose this metropolitan area network, the scale of the network will be the very large compared to the LAN and smaller than WAN. Next, which have little bit disadvantage, which is called as less security. Here the transmission media you are using is fiber optics or cables, and it requires more number of cables. To make a connection between different branches, it requires more number of cables. Next, we move on to the next type of network, which is called as WAN. So here the next type is wide area network. Here it covers the geographical area, the very wide range, the name itself only wide, which is in the sense of wide area, intercontinental distances, or one country with the other country, or one state with the another state. So the better example of having WAN is internet. So here the transmission media for connecting these wide area network will be telephone lines or satellite. Here the telephone lines provided by the telephone companies, or with the help of the satellite you may communicate or share your data with the help of these transmission media. It covers very large geographical area compared to the LAN and MAN, which covers very large area, larger it covers very larger area, either one country with another country or intercontinental distances. Here I will show one diagram regarding the WAN. This comes under one state and that comes under one state. This state have some city information and the government offices. All these are to be connected, interconnected with the help of some internet service providers. With the help of these providers, you may transfer the data from here to one city to the another city. Here city 2 and city 1. So these cities can share the information between one place to the another place with the help of this WAN structure. So the WAN is helpful to create the geographical area will be the more large. Here the transmission media here using is telephone lines or satellite. The lines can be provided by the telephone companies. After that, here it provides very high security. So in order to transfer your data in by using this type of network, the data is to be transferred with the help very high security nature. Here the sharing of data is also, sharing of data very effectively, efficiently. In order to restrict from the hackers, or in order to access the unauthorized users, we need firewalls. Here the firewall is nothing but only authorized persons only can access the data from one place to the another place. This is all about wide area network. The main point here is it covers very large geographical area, it provides high security, sharing of data very effectively, need firewalls. The better example of WAN structure is internet. Internet is a WAN structure. With the help of the internet, you know very well about the internet, how the data is to be transferred from one place to the another place with the help of internet. The internet, which is also known as a WAN structure, WAN, WAN structure. So the wide area network. So we move on to the next one, which is called as campus or corporate network. So the next type is campus or corporate area network. Here it covers the geographical area, which is larger than LAN, smaller than WAN and MAN. So the better example for having this network will be in universities or government offices. In government offices, you have so many number of building blocks. Those blocks can be interconnected with the help of this campus area network. Here the transmission media, the very very important point here is, here the transmission media is either wired or wireless, but it will choose wireless in order to make the efficient transmission of data between one place to the another place. It is very easy to install and economically benefit if you choose benefit. If you choose this network, it will economically benefit and it's very easy to install. Here the transmission media is using wireless technology rather than wired technology. One of the main advantage of having this network is higher data transfer rate. If you choose this network, the data will be higher data transmission rate. So the data will be transferred in higher rate without any loss of data. So here the main theme is, here you see the diagram here. This is one college campus. One building block contains the admin section and another contains the hostel section, another contains the library section. Within the university, you know very well about the university have so many number of buildings and so many number of departments. Each and every department have to communicate with the other. At the time of sharing the information, the transmission media is wireless. Effectively, it can transfer the data from one place to the another place. It is very economically benefit and it's have very higher data transfer rate. So this is all about our campus or corporate area network. So the next type of network is personal area network. It will covers the range up to only 10 meters. So in order to make an interconnection between different devices or computers, here the computer is going to be connected, interconnected with different devices. The range of this network will be only 10 meters. Very limited range. It may be either wired or wireless. The connecting media, here again we can use either wired or wireless. These are all the devices which are interconnected with the computer. The range of accessing the data between these two devices will be only 10 meters. This type of network is called as personal area network. It shares mails between photos, images, documents, and etc. So here these are all the devices. These kind of devices are connected to the PC with the help of either wired or wireless communication. The range here is only 10 meters. And also another facility of having PAN is, in order to wear a wearable computer device in your hand, it will also communicate with the computer within the specified range. For example, smartwatches. If you wear the smartwatch, the data is to be transferred to the computer in a network with the help of this PAN network. PAN, PAN, very limited size. The range will be only the 10 meters. It will be either wired or wireless. If you have wireless connection, choose the wireless connection. Otherwise, you choose wired communication between the devices. So this is the example regarding here. One computer is interconnected with all the devices in your system, in our place. Either mobile, you can connect mobile with PC using the USB, mouse with wire or without wire. iPad, here the iPad is also going to exchange or interchange the information between computer and iPad with the help of either wired or wireless, or the same thing, printer or laptop. Whatever the devices you are having, that devices can share the information within the range only up to 10 meters. This is all about personal area network. With this, we conclude the topic called as types of different networks. Once again, I am remembering what are the different types of networks. Here is LAN, after that MAN, third one WAN van, and the fourth one will be CAN can, and the fifth one will be PAN pan. Here LAN, the scope will within this, the range or scope of the geographical area will be very limited size. Here the man, larger than LAN and smaller than van, whereas van compared to the intercontinental distances are one country with the another country, whereas a can within the campus or university, within the university or within the government officials, whereas span very limited range, which is 10 meters only. These are the different types of networks are available in computer network. Based upon the scope and scale of your network, choose any one of this type. So the next topic is network topologies.